What's going down, Carl High?
I'm Adrian.
And I'm JD.
Today is February 20, 2018.
And this is Total Recap. For our first segment, we will check in with our weather team.
Thanks, guys. I hope you're having a great Tuesday, CHS. I'm Antonio here with your weather. Today's high, as you can see, is going to be 74 degrees, with the low dropping down to 67 degrees, keeping with the warm temperatures we've been having currently. As you can see, we also have an 80% chance of rain today, and it increases to 100% tomorrow. The rest of the week shows thunderstorms and rain, with the temperatures staying rather warm. So try to stay dry, Conroe High. That's it for me. Back to you guys.
Good morning, Mrs. Mui. Welcome to our newest segment on KTIG Real Talk. Thanks so much for joining us this morning. How are you?
I'm doing okay. Today's a good day.
That's good. Can you introduce yourself for those who don't know you?
Sure. I've been a staff member here at Conroe High School for the last 7 years, and this year I am teaching world history to 10th graders.
That's amazing. All your students know you've been battling cancer. Could you share with us a little bit about your journey?
My journey's been a long one. I actually started 14 years ago with my first bout of breast cancer. And then a couple years after that, I actually got a second cancer. And now this past summer, I was diagnosed again with breast cancer. So it's been a long, long journey.
I can tell. How hard has it been to juggle both home and work life?
Well, I'm a full-time mom to a 13-year-old, so that has its blessings, but it's also been difficult to be a mom and a wife, a teacher, and still go through all the treatments. The daily treatments that I've had to go through.
We've heard you've recently rung a bell. Could you tell us a little bit about that and what was going on inside?
Sure. So when you're finished with your cancer treatments, there's a bell at the cancer center, and you're supposed to ring it 3 times, and what it's supposed to signify is the end of your cancer journey and the start of your new chapter in your life, your healthy chapter in your life. And I was really proud a couple days ago to be able to ring that bell.
Do you have any advice for anyone who knows someone that's dealing with cancer right now?
Sure. One of the things that I would advise someone if they have a loved one that is dealing with cancer would be to ask them questions. Don't be afraid to ask them, what is radiation like? What is chemotherapy like? Because you hear those words, but most people don't really know what that person's going through. And being on a cancer journey can actually be a pretty lonely one. People ask you all the time, how are you? But they don't really know what's going on in your life, so feel comfortable asking that person some real questions, and I think it'll make that person feel better.
And what advice do you have on anyone that's actually dealing with cancer right now?
My advice for the people that are actually going through cancer, or if anyone watching this has cancer in their future, don't be ashamed of having cancer. There used to be a bad stigma attached to having cancer, where women would wear scarves or hats and be ashamed of going out natural. But you didn't ask for cancer, I didn't ask for cancer, so don't be ashamed of it. Be the warrior that you are. And I think the more people that walk around with their chin up and with their head exposed, I think that will make everybody else feel more comfortable if that ever happens to them in the future.
Very well said. Do you have any last words you'd like to say before we let you go?
Well, I really want to thank everybody here at Conroe High School, especially the administration and my fellow teachers and my friends. And most of all, I really want to thank Coach Marquis Sneed, who's my co-teacher this year. He has been my biggest supporter. And I definitely, truly am blessed to be a Conroe Tiger.
Well, Mrs. Mui, thanks for joining us this morning to tell your story. You've been very brave, and we're happy we can celebrate this victory with you. Now back to you guys in the studio.
Here are a few things happening here at CHS.
Today, the University of Houston will be in the CCC at 11 a.m. during lunch. Tomorrow, February 21st, the New York Film Academy will be in the CCC at 9 a.m. Sign up through Naviance to come visit with the representatives. February 27, 2018, Blaine College will be in the CCC at 11 a.m. during lunch.
Today, soccer is playing against Montgomery. The boys are home and the girls will be away. Come out and support.
Sub-varsity track meet home at 4 p.m. tomorrow. Come out and show support for our track team.
The Spanish National Honor Society needs all current senior members to check in with Ms. Young in room 410 by next Wednesday in order to receive your card for graduation.
Congratulations to both Alexis Tool and Oscar Perez for getting accepted into the University of Texas San Antonio.
Registration for this Saturday, February 24th, Conroe ISD Boot Camp for SAT ACT is closing soon. There are less than 50 seats remaining, so sign up today if you're interested.
Cost is $40 and seats are limited. Sign up today.
Emails with links to sign up were sent to all students' emails through Naviance.
The ACT was scheduled to be given here on February 27th has been moved to April 3rd.
If you cannot take it on this new date, please see Ms. Marin in the front office. There is still room for juniors only to sign up for the April 3rd ACT test.
You just need to tell Ms. Martin in the finance office to put you on the list. The cost is $35.
Gulf Coast Maintenance and Operations is offering a $1,000 scholarship, and the applications are available in the CCC. Come by and pick up your application today.
Thanks so much for watching. Make sure to follow us at KTIG News on all social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Tune in tomorrow for KTIG News.